بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم اقرأ باسم ربك
السلام عليكم. This video is about the prayers and lipids. In this video we will discuss the main definition of the prayers and lipids, their types, their importance, their sources, their differences, short and long chain fatty acids, concept of rancidity, concept of saponification and the saponification number, and brief information regarding the cholesterol. So let's start our video. Now, what are the fats and lipids? Fats and lipids constitute a very important nitrogenous group of organic substances that are present in either animal and as well as in plant tissues. And they are basically the esters of three fatty acids in their side chain and an alcohol of glycerol. So chemically, they are all esters. They contain fatty acid chain and they contain alcohol in the form of glycerol. So fat in the strict sense may specifically refer to the lipids that are solid at the room temperature, while lipids oil are those fats that are the lipids that are liquid at the room temperature. And if we talk about their general characteristics, they are hydrophobic and they are soluble in organic solvents, and they are mainly insoluble in the water. So this is the general introduction and definition of the fats and lipids. What are the sources? Depending upon the type of these fats, there are different types of sources of the fats. Sources, if we talk about the saturated fatty acids or saturated fats, the main sources are meats, butter, or dairy products. They are solid at room temperature, as we have discussed earlier. However, the problem with the saturated fat, what are saturated fats, we will discuss later. The saturated fats mainly responsible for the increment in the level of the bad cholesterol, that is the low density lipoprotein, which gets deposited in the blood vessels. They are responsible for the clogging or the blockade of the arteries. Other are the sources of the unsaturated fatty acids, and they are of mainly plant origin, and they are oil in nature. They are liquid at room temperature, and they have the capability to increase the good cholesterol, that is HDL, in the blood. LDL and VLDL are the broken down products of the bad fats. So dietary recommendation is the normal healthy person diet should contain about 45% monounsaturated fatty acid, which either present in the nuts, in the seeds, in various, for example, olive, and 35% of the dietary fat should contain the omega-3. What are omega-3? We will discuss later, which are present in nuts, in meat, and 20% of the dietary fat comprises of the saturated fatty acid. So our diet should not contain too much saturated fatty acids. Saturated fatty acids come from the butter, cheese, from the meat. There is a criteria provided by a scientist for Bluth. So Bluth criteria is for the lipids are that they are mainly insoluble in water, and there are variety of organic solvents in which they are soluble. They are ether, they are chloroform, either benzene, acetone, and they are mainly categorized as the fat solvents. relationship is also present along these fatty acids because they are the esters of the fatty acids. We have discussed already earlier in the previous video that what are fatty acids. And I think you all know that what are fatty acids. However, we will revise it. These fats and lipids have tendency to be utilized by the living organisms. And general type is that general type is the either they are oil, which is a liquid at ordinary room temperature. While we have fats, which are solid at room temperature, they are all esters of glycerol with higher fatty acids. So basic components are the fatty acids and the glycerols. Fatty acids are basically the hydrocarbon derivatives which contain carboxylic group in their side chain, and the chain length of the hydrocarbon is starting from the 4 carbon chain up to the 36 carbon chain. And if we talk about the nomenclature, we have discussed earlier that they are numbered on the basis of presence of the single and double bond. Saturated fatty acids are those which have no double bond, while unsaturated fatty acids are those which have one or more than one double bond in their ring structure. And unsaturated fatty acids are more preferred in our diet. Semicolon point, for example, palmitic acid is a saturated fatty acid having no no double bond in the length of the hydrocarbon chain. While oleic acid contains one double bond, and linoleic acid is contained two double bond in the hydrocarbon chain. So linoleic acid is more good as compared to oleic acid. Then if we talk about the alcohols, then two types of alcohol is present. Either it is the glycerol, which is mostly found, and in certain vaccines, higher alcohols like acetyl alcohol is also present, but it is an exceptional case, which is only present in the vaccines. Besides that, we have certain unsaturated alcohol as well. For example, in certain plant pigments like chlorophyll and lycopyl, polyunsaturated alcohol occurs in, as well as lycopyl is present in tomato, and most common lycopene is a pigment, lycopyl is present, just like chlorophyll. So you should remember that there is a chance that either saturated fatty acids are there or unsaturated fatty acids are there. So similar with that case, there may be a chance that there are certain unsaturated alcohol are also there in the lipid fats and lipids. What are the what is the importance of the fats and lipids? They are one of the most important dietary constituents, and they behave as a fuel in the body, just like carbohydrates. The first function is the fuel and energy providing to the body. In some respects, lipid is even superior to the carbohydrate as a raw material for the combustion because it provides more energy per gram. That is, 9.5 calories per gram are produced. As compared to the carbohydrate, the which is about 4.0 calorie per gram. Yani, agar hum ye kahe, so carbohydrates are providing the energy that is 4.0 calorie per gram, while fats are providing energy 9.5 calorie per gram. More energy is provided by the fats and lipids. Second important thing is that they can be stored in the body in almost unlimited amount in contrast to carbohydrates. कार्बोहाइड्रेट की एक पर्टिकुलर लिमिट है, उससे ज़्यादा वो स्टोर नहीं हो सकते. अदरवाइज उसके अंदर ग्लाइकोजन का एक स्टोरेज पोर्शन होता है एंड मसल्स में भी होता है, लेकिन उसकी एक लिमिट है. हाउएवर फॉर दी फैट एंड लिपिड्स स्टोरेज इज अनलिमिटेड, एंड ओबेसिटी का मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट कॉज जो है वो फैट एंड लिपिड्स की डिपोजिशन है इन द एब्डोमेन इन द बॉडी. सो कि उसकी कोई हमारे पास एक लिमिट नहीं है नेचर की तरफ से कि जो उसको स्टॉप कर सके. तो दे इज अनलिमिटेड अमाउंट, दे कैन बी डिपॉजिटेड इन अनलिमिटेड अमाउंट इन आवर बॉडी. सम these deposits of lipids have a useful effect as well. ये नहीं है कि सिर्फ कि obesity है तो तमाम के तमाम fats बेकार हैं. No. Some deposits of lipids may exert an insulating effect in the body, while they also provide protection around internal organs like kidney, and they provide padding and protect the organs. ठीक है. So they provide insulation and they provide protection by covering several organs of the body. They are the building material, and breakdown of the product of the fats can be utilized by building of the and the development of the biological membranes. Furthermore, there are certain essential fatty acids. Essential fatty acids are those which cannot be synthesized by our body. And so in this sense they are essential in our diet for our normal health and growth. Otherwise our nervous system will not work properly, because our nervous system is mainly dependent upon the lipids, especially certain type of lipids, essentially for the proper functioning. Besides these, several types of fat soluble vitamins are also there, which are not dissolved, which are not absorbed in our body if we have not proper fat storage. So lipid is necessary for these vitamins as well. We have certain type of natural membranes which are comprised of the lipoproteins and phospholipids. These are two important proteins. Phospholipids especially responsible for the formation of natural membranes like cell walls, like cell organelles, like mitochondria. So it is very important for the formation of the cell membrane. It is lipid bilayer. Lipid bilayer means two layers of lipids are there in the are required for the formation of the membrane. Then we have certain carrier proteins which are lipoproteins, and they are basically responsible for the transportation of various substances. An example is the example are the phospholipase in the body. For example, they are carriers of the triglycerides, they are carrier of the cholesterol. So they are basically responsible for the very important constituent of the diet. It is very essential to take it in our diet in a specific amount. We will elaborate the importance or biomedical importance one by one as well. The picture show the the phospholipids, and they are basically the member of the lipid family. Phospholipid is a conjugated lipid. It contains glycerol, it contains fatty acid, and it contains phosphorus containing compound. And due to the phospholipid, for example, is the lecithin. Lecithin is an example of the phospholipid, and it consists of the water soluble head and a fat soluble tail. This phospholipid convert it into a water soluble moiety. So phospholipids are the phosphorus containing compound. We have triacylglycerol. They are the fatty acid ester linked with one glycerol molecule. Fatty acid may be the same or they may be different. So natural triglycerols are mostly mixture of different types of fatty acids. Are the triglycerols are non-polar? Yes, they are. Each three of fatty acids molecule undergo an acidification with one hydroxy group of the glycerol moiety, because the long chain carbon chain the triglycerides are nearly polar molecule and thus do not easily dissolve in the polar water. So basically triglycerides are also non-polar just like other lipids. What are the functions of triglycerol? They are mainly responsible for the storage and insulation, as we have discussed earlier, and they provide energy, especially in cold weather. And usually they are mostly present in the eukaryotes, in the vertebrates. What are the sources of triglycerol? They are natural fats, they are vegetables such as corn and olive oil. They are composed of triglycerol. What are the advantages? As we have discussed, they are providing twice energy as the oxidation of carbohydrates. They are hydrophobic. they are stored, human stored fat in the body, they are present in the form of triglycerols, not in the other form. Basically, in human ke andar jo storage hai, wo triglycerol ke form mein hai. Carbohydrates have advantages over fat, however, because ke carbohydrate mein energy ki calories ko kam hai. However, they are readily and quick source of the metabolic energy, and glucose is readily soluble in water. So, in those condition in which acute hame agar chahiye hoti energy rice, to phir hum carbohydrate dete hain, na ki lipids. Lipids ki calorie providing zyada hai, lekin uska metabolism slow hai as compared to carbohydrate. Long chain fatty acids and long chain may behave as a water repellent, and they are basically used in the manufacturing of lotion, ointments and polishes, and these are basically those functions which are not present in the body. Basically ye inka pharmaceutical function hai ki jisme ye they are work as a water repellent, and especially in the form of wax. These wax, carnauba wax, they are extracted and they are used as a lotion, emulsifying agent in a pharmaceutical industry. Fuel ko hum discuss kar chuke hain, and they are the principal source form of the energy. And structural components bhi hai organic matter ka. Other lipids hamare paas hain jo ki beside the cell membrane enzymes bhi hain. We have certain cofactors are there, which are basically lipids, and they are participating in the electron carriers. They are light absorbing pigments, they are emulsifying agent in our digestive tract, or they may be a certain hormones which are lipid in nature. They are certain intracellular messengers jo ke lipids hote hain. Theek hai, so we will discuss further is pe thode bahut hum basically intracellular messengers ko hum nada discuss karenge, aur puri aapki jo pharmacology hai उसमें आप इंट्रासेलुलर मैसेंजर्स एंड हार्मोन्स एंड डिफरेंट रिसेप्टर्स को ही आप डिस्कस करते रहेंगे. सर्टेन पिगमेंट और ऑल्सो देयर, हम थोड़ा सा इंट्रासेलुलर मैसेंजर्स के बारे में देख लेते हैं कि इंट्रासेलुलर मैसेंजर्स आर दोज मैसेंजर्स जो कि एक मैसेज ट्रांसफर करते हैं फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू द अनदर, एंड द मोस्ट कॉमन मैसेंजर इज द इनोसिटोल फॉस्फोलिपिड्स, जो कि फॉस्फोलिपिड है बेसिकली, एंड फॉस्फोलिपिड इज अ टाइप ऑफ लिपिड. So in response to the extracellular signal, protein bind to this phospholipid and they form a complex to protein, and the protein is present on the surface of the plasma membrane. So they transfer the message, they are the messenger. So ye apna message jo hai wo transfer karte hain, aur jo messenger hai wo basically lipid in nature hai. Furthermore, we have the membrane which are comprised of sphingolipids, and sphingolipids basically are the member है जो कि एक और member है for the source of the intracellular messenger, and they are present basically in the nerves. Lipids may be by the signals and cofactors in pigment, and the most important hormones are the eicosanoids. Eicosanoids are the basically prostaglandins, and these prostaglandins are आप पूरी फार्मेसी में दे यू विल स्टडी दी प्रोस्टाग्लैंडिन एंड व्हाट बेसिकली प्रोस्टाग्लैंडिन आर दी लिपिड्स, एंड दे आर दी सब्सटेंसेस एंड दैट मे एक्ट इन अ पैराक्राइन मैनर. व्हाट इज पैराक्राइन मैनर? पैराक्राइन मैनर आर द मैनर इन विच द सब्सटेंस एक्ट ओनली ऑन द सेल्स नियर द पॉइंट ऑफ द सिंथेसिस इंस्टेड ऑफ बीइंग ट्रांसपोर्टेड इन टू द ब्लड सेल्स, एंड they are termed as the paracrine hormones. The examples are the prostaglandin, tromboxane, and leukotrienes. Whenever there is an inflammation, there is any outer trigger, or there is any tissue injury, several mediators, several prostaglandins are released in a paracrine manner. उसी जगह पे basically release होते हैं जहाँ पे tissue damage होता है, और वहाँ पे जो है वो basically increase करते हैं and chemotaxis करते हैं, and they attract the WBC towards their site, and they provide a signal that there is a problem. So they are the part of the immunity. So eicosanoids are the derivative of the arachidonic fatty acids, and these are the types. They are fever, and they are those mediators, they are those messengers which are mainly involved in the inflammation, in the fever, in the pain, in associated with the tissue injury or due to infection, or they are also helpful for the prevention measures, like in to prevent the gastric acid secretion or to prevent the stomach from the acidic secretion of the food. यानी ये क्या करते हैं कि for example certain prostaglandins are there जो कि stomach की line को protect करते हैं कि acid उनको deteriorate ना करते. They are also involved in the formation of blood clots and like platelets, and they are also involved in the regulation of blood pressure as well. Now another topic is the okay, there are certain fat soluble vitamin as well. So vitamin D, vitamin E and vitamin K are basically two vitamin A, four vitamins are there which are fat soluble vitamins. So vitamin A is basically responsible for the visual visualization through the eye and retinal. उसकी जो है वो एक्टिव फॉर्म है जो कि इन्वॉल्व है फॉर द रीजन. रीजन में बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट हार्मोन है वाइटामिन ए प्रेजेंट इन कैरेट. वाइटामिन डी फॉर द बोन्स. पॉलीकैल्सिफेरॉल है और ये फिर बाद में एक्टिवेट होता है एंड इट इज बेसिकली रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द अपटेक ऑफ कैल्शियम इन द इंटेस्टाइन एंड रेगुलेट्स द कैल्शियम लेवल इन द किडनी एंड द बोन्स. वाइटामिन ई इज बेसिकली एंटीऑक्सीडेंट है जो कि बॉडी के अंदर जितनी भी हमारे पास टॉक्सिक कंपाउंड प्रोड्यूस होते हैं वो डिटॉक्सीफाई करता है. वाइटामिन ई. वाइटामिन के जो है वो ब्लड क्लॉट फॉर्मेशन में बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है एंड दे आर ऑल फैट सॉल्युबल वाइटामिन. नाउ देयर आर सेवरल टाइप्स ऑफ क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ द लिपिड्स. आइदर दे आर क्लासिफाइड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ सिंपली देयर स्ट्रक्चर एंड आइदर दे आर क्लासिफाइड ऑन देयर फंक्शन. So on the basis of their structure, we have four types of classes: simple lipids, compound lipids, derived lipids, and miscellaneous type. So on the basis of structure, as we have discussed earlier, that lipids are mainly comprised of fatty acids and glycerols. And fatty acids are further divided into saturated fatty acids and the unsaturated fatty acids. Furthermore, lipids are further classified in non-glyceride lipids, for example, waxes, sphingolipids, and steroids, in which we have no glycerol portion. Instead of, we have other type of alcohol. We have no glycerol in these type of non-glyceride lipids. While we have glycerides, in which the major portion is glycerol. Among them, we have neutral glyceride or phospholipids, and we have complex lipid, and we have lipoproteins. If we talk about in details, then we have simple lipids or homolipids. Homolipids or simple lipids are those which contain only simple fatty acid and glycerol. They are either fats or they are waxes. ठीक है. आई थिंक ये क्लियर है. ट्राइग्लिसराइड्स होते हैं ये और या वैक्सीज होते हैं. वैक्सीज क्या होती हैं? वैक्सीज वो होती हैं जिसमें ग्लिसरॉल्स नहीं होते हैं बल्कि हायर मॉलिक्यूलर वेट के अल्कोहल्स होते हैं. देन वी हैव कंपाउंड लिपिड्स. कंपाउंड लिपिड एट द नेम इंडिकेट दैट दे आर द एस्टर ऑफ द फैटी एसिड कंटेनिंग ग्रुप अदर देन फैटी एसिड एंड अल्कोहल. यानी अल्कोहल एंड फैटी एसिड के अलावा इसके अंदर कोई और भी कंपाउंड एड होता है. फॉर एग्जाम्पल दे आर फॉस्फोलिपिड्स, दे आर ग्लाइकोलिपिड्स. फॉस्फोलिपिड्स आर दोज लिपिड्स जिसमें एक्स्ट्रा जो एडिशनल मॉइटी है वो फॉस्फोएट की है. ग्लाइकोलिपिड्स में कोई भी कार्बोहाइड्रेट का की मॉइटी उसमें एडेड है. तो फॉस्फोलिपिड्स दे आर द सब्स्टिट्यूटेड फैट कंटेनिंग एडिशनल टू फैटी एसिड एंड ग्लिसरॉल आर फॉस्फोरिक एसिड रेसिड्यू आर नाइट्रोजीनियस बेस और एनी अदर सब्स्टिट्यूएंट्स. एग्जाम्पल है हमारे पास ट्रिपैलिन, फॉस्फाटिडाइल, इनोसिटोल जो कि हमने डिस्कस की है, प्लाज्मोलिन, स्पिंजोमाइलिन एक्सेट्रा. ग्लाइकोलिपिड्स कंटेनिंग कार्बोहाइड्रेट मॉइटी एंड दे आर दे कंटेन अ स्पेशल अल्कोहल कॉल्ड स्पिंजो सी और स्पिंजोल एंड आर नाइट्रोजीनियस बेस अलोंग विद द फैटी एसिड्स. बट इसमें फॉस्फोरस ग्रुप नहीं होता. उसके अंदर फर्दर इसकी क्लासेस हैं विच इज सेरिब्रोसाइड एंड गैंग्लियोसाइड डिपेंडिंग अपॉन दियर लिक्वेशन. ये गैंग्लिया में है या सेरिब्रम में है तो ये दे आर फर्दर क्लासिफाइड. अदर अदर टाइप है हमारे पास सल्फोलिपिड्स जिसमें दे आर कैरेक्टराइज्ड बाय द प्रेजेंस ऑफ द सल्फेट ग्रुप, अमाइनो लिपिड्स, प्रोटीओलिपिड्स व्हिच आर ड्यू टू द टेलिन ऑफ अमाइनो ग्रुप इन द लिपिड्स, लिपोप्रोटीन्स ड्यू टू द लिपिड एज अ प्रोस्टेटिक ग्रुप टू द प्रोटीन, यानी प्रोटीन के अंदर लिपिड एज अ प्रोस्टेटिक ग्रुप मौजूद है। प्रोस्टेटिक ग्रुप क्या होता है? वो ग्रुप द ग्रुप व्हिच इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द एक्टिविटी ऑफ द सब्सटेंस। देन वी हैव डिराइव्ड लिपिड्स। Derived lipids are those derivative of the lipids which are obtained by the hydrolysis of the lipids, either the simple lipids or either of the compound lipids. So they are the derivatives, they are not the pure ones. So derivatives जो हैं वो basically हमारे पास secondary metabolites होते हैं and they derivative जो हैं basically they are responsible for the different types of pharmacological activities. और ये फार्माकोलॉजिकली नेचर में बहुत ही ज़्यादा हमारे पास वैरायटी है जो कि डिराइव लिपिड्स की है। अमंग देम सब एग्जांपल्स आर दी स्टीरॉइड्स, टर्पीन्स एंड कॉर्टिकोस्टीरॉइड्स एंड सर्टेन पिगमेंट्स जो भी हैं वो सब के सब इसमें हमारे पास डिराइव लिपिड्स में आते हैं। देन वी हैव अदर टाइप ऑफ मिसेलेनियस लिपिड्स लाइक कैरोटीनॉइड्स, वी हैव स्क्वालीन एटसेट्रा। Another classification of the lipid is on the basis of their function. Function के हिसाब से भी इनको classify किया गया है। So first function is the, for example, हमारे पास fuel का था। So the main function is the storage lipids. So fats and oils are stored in a plant and they are stored energy form. So they are storage energy storage lipids. Then we have structural lipids which are responsible for the formation of any structural components of the cell, among which we have membrane lipids, spongiolipids, galactolipids and sterols. If you talk about the membrane lipids, you can see that the lipid bilayer is basically comprised of phospholipids, glycolipids and ether lipids. So फर्दर सी दैट मेम्ब्रेन लिपिड्स के अंदर ये तीन टाइप के हमारे पास लिपिड्स होते हैं। फॉस्फोलिपिड्स आर इज बेसिकली ग्लिसरॉल फॉस्फोलिपिड्स, इसमें ग्लिसरॉल विद फैटी एसिड प्रेजेंट है। हमें पता है ना कि फैटी एसिड एंड ग्लिसरॉल मिलके सिंपल बनाते हैं, लेकिन इसमें फॉस्फेट भी मौजूद है अलॉन्ग विद अल्कोहल एनी अदर अल्कोहल इंस्टेड ऑफ ग्लिसरॉल। देन वी हैव स्पिंजोलिपिड्स, हमने डिस्कस किया अभी कि इसमें फॉस्फेट एंड कोलीन मीन्स प्रोटीन मौजूद है अलॉन्ग विद फैटी एसिड्स। Then we have spinjo, further spinjo lipids है जो कि mono and disaccharide जो कि galactolipids glycolipids हैं। इसमें हमारे पास carbohydrate moiety in the form of mono and disaccharides present है। Then we have galactol lipids or sulfolipids in which we have either mono disaccharide along with the sulfate moiety. All these type of lipids are responsible for the formation of the bilayer membrane of the lipid membrane which is bilayer, and due to these type of substances like phosphate group, like sulfate group, like this phosphate group, and they causing the membrane to have a two type of segment. One is amphipathic and other is packed in bilayer which is hydrophilic and hydrophobic. Both characteristic are present in this lipid bilayer membrane and they due to these special type of lipids. These are the further structure of the glycerol phospholipids in which we have the phosphate moiety. All have phosphate moiety. You can see three phosphate moiety. Spongiolipids are those which contain long chain of amino acid along with fatty acid and glycerols. ठीक है, तो ग्लिस्ट्रो फॉस्फोलिपिड्स एंड गैलेक्टो फॉस्फोलिपिड्स कंटेन ग्लिस्ट्रॉल एंड स्पिंजोलिपिड्स कंटेन दी स्पिंजो सी विच इज अमाइनो एसिड। अबाउट 60 डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ स्पिंजोलिपिड्स आर प्रेजेंट एंड सेवरल क्लासेस आर देयर एंड दे आर प्रेजेंट इन प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन ऑफ एनिमल सेल्स, इन माइलिन एंड माइलिन शीट होती है जो कि नर्वस सिस्टम के अंदर अराउंड में पाई जाती है। They are cerebrosides, globosides and neural glycolipids and gangliosides. They are very important type of lipids present in the human body or the, in of them are pigments of the neurons, and they are responsible for the recognition site on the cell surface. And the carbohydrate moiety of certain sphingolipids define the human blood groups. Ganglioside are concentrated in the outer surface of the cells, and they are the point of recognition of the extracellular molecule or surface of the neighboring cells. Galactolipids are mainly present in plant cells and in chloroplast, in other type of membrane lipids, for example, sulfolipids, monogalactoside lipids. Then ether lipids, they are mainly present in the bacteria or other type of microorganisms and in some vertebrates. And membranes of certain bacteria contain this type of ether lipids. These are not ester, these are ether lipids. It means ke iske andar jo oxygen hai, beech mein oxygen hai, instead of ester. Ye ester nahi hai, ether hai. Then we have sterols. Sterols, ek specific type of steroid nucleus hai, pentasteroid nucleus, jisme 5 benzene rings takriban usme present hoti hai. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So cholesterol is the major uska region hai. And ये एक स्पेशल टाइप ऑफ स्ट्रक्चर है जो कि नॉर्मली प्रेजेंट होता है तमाम यूकेरियोट्स में, और बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट फंक्शन जो है वो परफॉर्म करता है कोलेस्ट्रॉल. एंड इट हैज एम्फीपैथिक वन एंड व्हिच इज द पोलर वन, द बेंजीन रिंग इसमें मौजूद है, सॉरी बैक हो गया. एंड सो कोलेस्ट्रॉल इज द मेजर स्टेरॉल फाउंड इन द एनिमल टिश्यू. It is responsible for the formation of the membrane. It is responsible for the formation of steroid hormones like progesterone, testosterone, estradiol, aldosterone. In sab ka jo major structure hai wo yahi hai. Aur bile acid, isme dekh lein aapko koi aapko ester nahi lag raha, na koi fatty acid lag raha hai, balki they are basically arrangement of the certain four fused benzene rings and three are 6 carbon and one is 5 carbon. जितने भी bile acid derivatives हैं, they are the derivatives of the cholesterol. They act as an emulsifying agent and act as detergent in the intestine, causing the emulsification of the dietary fats to make them readily accessible to the digestive enzyme lipases. होता क्या है कि हमारे पास जो fatty lipids हैं, स्ट्रॉन्ग हमारे पास एस्टर्स हैं, उनको वो ट्राइग्लिसराइड जो कि मोनोमर होते हैं उनमें ब्रेक डाउन कर देते हैं, और उसके लिए लाइपेजेस इंजाइम होते हैं इंटेस्टाइन में, दे आर प्लेइंग देयर पार्ट. आई थिंक लेक्चर जो है वो बहुत लंबा हो रहा है, वी हैव टू समराइज इट. पॉली अनसैचुरेटेड फैट्स एंड हाइड्रोजन इंजिनेशन हम डिस्कस कर चुके हैं. सिस एंड ट्रांस फैट होते हैं एंड ड्यू टू द अनसैचुरेशन हमारे पास जो है वो उसकी ओरिएंटेशन चेंज हो सकती है. स्ट्रक्चर हम देख चुके हैं इसका, ये हमारे इम्पोर्टेंट नहीं है. अदर फॉस्फोलिपिड्स भी हैं, वी आर स्किपिंग, हम ये डिस्कस कर चुके हैं, इट इज ऑल सब रिपीट हो रहे हैं. हमारे पास लिपोप्रोटीन्स, हमने आप डिस्कस किया था कि लिपोप्रोटीन्स आर द मैसेंजर्स ऑफ, तो लिपोप्रोटीन एक प्रोटीन है, अमोनो लेयर ऑफ द फॉस्फोलिपिड्स है, और उसके अंदर बेसिकली कंप्राइज ऑफ कोलेस्ट्रॉल, वो कोट जो है वो कोलेस्ट्रॉल का है, एंड एस्टर ऑफ सम ट्राइग्लिसराइड है, उसके ऊपर जो है वो एपोप्रोटीन्स मौजूद है. एंड देयर आर वी हैव डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ लिपोप्रोटीन्स, VLDL. बेसिकली जो कोलेस्ट्रॉल है इन द बॉडी इट इज सर्कुलेटेड इन द ब्लड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ लिपोप्रोटीन्स. लिपोप्रोटीन्स वो बना लेते हैं, और लिपिड और प्रोटीन्स के साथ मिलकर जो है वो पूरी ब्लड के अंदर सर्कुलेट होते हैं. तो वी एल डी एल वेरी लो डेंसिटी प्रोटीन है, उसका सेकंड हाईएस्ट इन कोलेस्ट्रॉल है बाय वेट. देन वी हैव इंटरमीडिएट डेंसिटी लिपोप्रोटीन, वी हैव लो डेंसिटी लिपोप्रोटीन, ऑल दी थ्री आर बैड कोलेस्ट्रॉल. अगर उनकी एक पर्टिकुलर अमाउंट है ब्लड में उससे एक्सीड होगी, दे विल स्टार्ट गेटिंग डिपॉजिट इन द ब्लड वेसल. बेसिकली दे आर प्रेजेंट इन द ब्लड vessels, they are transporter proteins. HDL and HDL जो है वो हमारी बहुत ही अच्छी प्रोटीन है, जो कि अगर ब्लड में हाई होगी तो वो ब्लड की इंटीग्रिटी मेंटेन करेगी विथ लो इंटीग्रिटी ऑफ एथेरोस्क्लेरोसिस. मेन इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक्स हमारे पास हैं जो कि मैं अलग वीडियो में पूरी उसकी स्पेसिफिकली डिस्कस करूंगी। हावेवर टू क्राइटेरिया हैं जो कि हम यहाँ पे करेंगे, वो है एसिड नंबर की एंड एसिड नंबर एंड सपोनिफिकेशन नंबर। इन आवर लैब वी विल परफॉर्म सर्टेन केमिकल रिएक्शन इन विच वी रिलाइज दी फैट्स एंड लिपिड्स। इसमें करेंगे क्या, बेसिकली वी विल डिटरमिन दी एसिड नंबर एंड दी सपोनिफिकेशन नंबर। एसिड नंबर अगर हम देखें तो इट इज बेसिकली द नंबर ऑफ मिलीग्राम ऑफ द पोटेशियम हाइड्रोक्साइड व्हिच इज रिक्वायर्ड टू न्यूट्रलाइज द फ्री फैटी एसिड प्रेजेंट इन 1 ग्राम ऑफ फैट। मींस वी विल टेक 1 ग्राम ऑफ फैट, अगर हमको सिंपलीफाई करें तो 1 ग्राम ऑफ फैट के लिए कितने नंबर ऑफ मिलीग्राम ऑफ पोटेशियम हाइड्रोक्साइड है दे विल रिक्वायर टू न्यूट्रलाइज द फ्री फैटी एसिड प्रेजेंट इन अ सैंपल। इट इज अ रिलेटिव मेजर ऑफ द डेंसिटी as free fatty acids are normally formed during the decomposition of the triglyceride. It means in normal fats, in normal lipids, there is no free fatty acid present or very less number of free fatty acid are present as compared to the older one. So this is a criteria by which we can identify old or new fat sample with the help of the acid number. Those who have low acid number, it means the sample is fresh or it is not degraded. While those sample who have high acid number, it means that the sample is degraded. We will discuss later in detail type of rancidity etc. So on the basis of acid number, we have the rancidity, which is the deterioration of the fatty acid, which leads to the development of the unpleasant smell and color in fats and oils, and it reduces the nutritional value of the food by degradation. Okay, we have certain types of acidity we will discuss later in second video. Then we have saponification. Saponification is basically we hydrolyze the whole fat, whole part of the fat, and by hydrolysis the complete fat is transferred into the free fatty acid. Means उसमें होगा क्या कि पूरे के पूरे fats को हमने hydrolyze कर दिया कि उसके अंदर जो fatty acids हैं they become free. जितने fatty acids हैं वो सब के साथ उसमें free हो गए. The hydrolysis of fats by an alkali is result in the formation of the soap and the glycerol. तो जो hydrolysis है उसके बाद जो compound बनेगा वो होगा soap. तो जब इसको कहा है saponification number. So the saponification number is the number of milligram of the potassium hydroxide, same potassium hydroxide जो कि हमने acid number के लिए use किया था. The saponification number में difference क्या है? The saponification number is the number of milligram of potassium hydroxide required to neutralize the fatty acid resulting from the complete hydrolysis of the 1 gram of fat. So 1 gram of the fat, the sample is same, but in this case complete hydrolysis will be carried out during the experiment, and after hydrolysis total amount of free fatty acid will be present is get reacted with the potassium hydroxide, and this potassium hydroxide will convert the fat into the soap. I think I can clear I have clear the difference between the acid number and saponification. However, we will further discuss it in other videos or lectures. Thank you for watching.